Introducing the all-new Origami Light Switch that really works. Alright, so it doesn't really turn on and off a light, but it does turn on and off. The idea to design an Origami Light Switch was from my student Lucas during his Zoom tutoring session with me. During the session, we tried to design a switch, but it ended up being a two-way reclining chair. Recline like this, and recline like this, which is pretty cool. Wee-hee! Oh, it can be a chair like that, too. And I just designed this on the spot because I needed a person. I don't know if I'm going to teach this. I think it needs some work. That'll be another 50 tries. After the session, I resumed the challenge on my own, and over the course of about 50 tries, it evolved to this model. And that's what I'm going to teach you in this tutorial. Ready, set, here goes! Alright, so for this light switch, I'm going to use a 7-inch square of Kami. And I'm going to make a white light switch on a colored light switch cover. That way, you can use your decorative Kami with good results. Alright, begin colored side up and fold diagonally in half. Try to make really precise folds and crease sharply. Unfold and fold the edge to the crease. Now this is a rather challenging model, so if you're new to folding, I do not recommend this model. But if you're up for the challenge, let's continue. And repeat. Fold the flap over the edges. Wrap it tightly over the edges. And unfold and tuck it underneath these two flaps. Fold this flap up, aligning with this edge. And repeat. Unfold and turn over and bend the top down. We're not folding yet. Make these two corners touch. Hold it together so it doesn't slide. Fold the front flap up so that the fold aligns with this crease. And unfold the back. So if you did that right, this corner should land on this vertical crease. If it doesn't, adjust it so that it does. Unfold, and now we're going to rabbit ear to this crease. So first, fold like this, right to the crease. Unfold and repeat. Unfold and pinch the corner like this, and flatten to the right, and to the left. Rotate, and unfold here, and fold this edge to this edge. So we're just folding the front layer, so the edges align, and crease to there. And unfold, and refold this flap. Now turn over top to bottom and fold so that this corner, this point, touches the intersection of the creases. And hold the layers together so that they don't slide. And when you flatten, try to make this even. And rotate. And now we're going to sink this point. But first, fold this corner to the middle. And crease it sharply. And now fold this flap up like this and crease this sharply. And unfold these two flaps and unfold this flap. So here we have the triangle that we're going to sink on. So pinch around the edges of the triangle. Notice how my finger is behind to provide support. Okay, pinch like this. And the sink is complete. All right. Now reverse fold on the existing crease. Like that. So this is the switch, and we're going to lock these corners together. And how? Like this. Open here, and open here, and lift this front layer up. And now fold on this existing crease so that this point goes to the intersection of the creases. Right there. Like that. And now we're going to reclose it. So wrap this flap over this edge. And it helps if you first just curl this so that it will go cleanly into the pocket. Like that. And now remake the sink. And now the switch looks nice and clean. All right, fold up and down. A couple times. All right, and now fold in half. All right, open. And now we're going to make the switch so that it aligns with this diagonal. So holding on like this, just pivot it so that this edge aligns with the diagonal. And now reclose, and you're going to make the new fold right there. All right, rotate, and fold this flap up. How far? We're folding right on this point, right there. So we're folding pretty close to the top. And we want this fold to be even all the way across. So it's like that. And turn over and fold this flap up. Aligning it with that point. And aligning these edges and these edges and these edges. Okay, all around. All right, so that's what it looks like. Now we're going to move the switch to the other side. So first, go back to its home base, which was there, and now rotate it to this position. And it should go the same angle as it went to the other side. So it's like that, and make it go back to both sides. So when it's open like this, you can see how it easily goes to both positions. But it's best if we can get it so that it's closed and it moves easily. So go to this position, and now just go halfway a little bit and squeeze. And in each position, as you pivot it, you want to squeeze. Pinch, 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 pinch in all of the positions. And now it should be able to slide as you pinch it. Yeah. Okay, good enough. All right, now we're going to open like this and lift this flap up. What we're going to do is we're going to lock these two points together. So this is the way to do it. Hold right here and lift this flap up. And when you do that, this should become diagonal. Like that. So this is 90 degrees and this is diagonal. And now fold this flap over to this side. Like that, turn back over, and fold this flap over to this same side, and now flatten like this. So we make a new little fold right there, and turn over and fold this flap to the other side. And turn back over. And now comes the fun step. We're going to rotate and fold this flap into this pocket. And as you do that, the switch will pivot to the other side like that. So it goes into the pocket, all the way back into the pocket like that. So it's in there. And now turn over again and lift this flap up. And if you did that correctly, these two points should be locked. And we have an airplane with a gear shift. There's the airplane. It doesn't fly though, so anyway. All right, now we're going to first close it like this. First close it. Now fold this edge to the top. And turn over and repeat. And open here. Now we're going to lock these flaps in. How are we going to do that? Like this. Open here and lift this flap up, but keep this folded. So it's like this. So this should be diagonal. And repeat. And turn over and wrap these flaps over the edge. All right, so this is what it looks like. Now we're going to tuck the flaps into these pockets. There's the pocket. And we're actually going to fold we're going to fold between this point and this point. So write a mountain fold that goes diagonal. So open the pocket and tuck it in like this. And go all the way in as far as it can go. So it's like that. It'll get folded again inside there. And repeat. Like that. All right, now this is optional. If you want to clean this flap up and this flap up and these flaps, this is what to do. But this is the back side, so it doesn't really matter. You could skip this, but I'm gonna do it. So unfold here and unfold here. And now fold this flap between this point and this point, like that, and repeat. And unfold this flap and fold on the first crease. And same thing here. Unfold this flap, fold on the first crease. And now fold these flaps up and fold this flap into the pocket. And into the pocket. And that just makes it a little bit cleaner. All right, now turn over. And this is locked right here. Now, spread open here, but this should remain locked. And now fold the corner over and tuck it inside the pocket underneath the switch. So slide it in there, like that. As far in as it goes comfortably, and now make the fold. And now fold in half, like this. And fold on the crease, like this. All right, so here's the light switch, but this we want to close. So if you want, you could just fold this over like this, and the light switch works. It should work. There we go. Yeah. All right, let's fold it like this and just flatten it really well all over the place. And close it like this, and once again, flatten it all over. Okay, so fold this flap over to this side and unfold, and might as well go to this side too. And back to this side. All right, so that's a nice loose fold. And all right, we're gonna connect these two points in the same way that we connected these. Now this is challenging, so if you want, you really could just leave it like this and there's your light switch. But here goes, we're gonna connect them. And this is the hardest step of the whole model. All right, so pull this out and now make it go into this position like we did on the other side. There's the diagonal. And now we're going to collapse it to this side. And the object is we want to get this flap, this point, into this groove. And now you should be able to just kind of push that flap inside like that. And hopefully that will lock these two points together. And now we need to get this point back where it was. So holding these points together and these points together, spread out here like it was. So it bulges like that. And now open here and insert underneath. Underneath there, right into there. That's tricky. It helps to lift the switch up. Okay, so it gets in there. And this came undone somehow. Okay, go back in there. All right. And there it is. And flatten it. Now, I kind of just like it like this because it's so clean. But if you really want it 3D like this, well, here's how to do it. All right. Open here and pretend like you're going to make a squash, but don't squash on the whole thing. Just squash the tip, however wide you want the switch to be. So right there. And now take this flap and fold it on top like that and pinch. And now define the front by pinching here and here. Like that. And now form the top. But watch out, don't go too far in there because those are delicate folds, and in order for the action to really work, we don't want to three-dimensionalize the interior. So just go about to here like that and shape it to taste. All right, that's pretty good. And now it still works. And there you have it. That was a tough tutorial. I hope that you guys were able to follow it. I struggled to make it, but hopefully you got something like that. So hope you guys enjoyed this model and enjoy playing with your fidget switch. And see you guys later. It's also Flickr.
Lucas and I just designed a double-sided chair. It can be like this way or this way, and it can recline, and it can recline, and it can even flatten and become a bed. I've heard of a magic carpet. This is a magic recliner chair. Yeah.